Thank you, Jesus. Holy are you, Lord. All creation call you Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Worthy is the Lamb. We worship your majesty. Hey, awesome God. I know you, you are God. How great thou art. You are God.
Let me raise up. Thank you, Jesus. What a mighty God we say. What a mighty God we say. The angel bow before you, Lord, to worship and adore you. What a mighty God I see. What a mighty God I see. Yeah.
Hallelujah to the name of the Lord. We glorify your name. We bless your holy name. We magnify your name. You are the healer of our souls, the healer of our lives. Jehovah is your name. We bless you, Jesus. Blessed be unto the name of the Lord. Glory be unto the name of Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Ora kasiti rebushi, yande rebusi ataraka, mamandi kete rebeshi anda. I've seen your greatness, Lord. I've seen your anointing, Jesus. I've seen your love, Almighty God. I've seen Heavenly Father, the greatness that is found in your kingdom. Father, you are still the same God of yesterday, the God of Abraham, the God of Jacob, the God of Moses, the God of Isaac. Oh God, you are still the same God. We believe in your name. We trust in your name. We believe in the power that is found in your name. We believe in the grace that is found in your name. We believe in everything, Heavenly Father, that is found in your kingdom. I trust in you, Lord. I trust in you, Jesus. Blessed be unto the name of the Lord. Thank you, Spirit of the Lord. I give you all the glory and I give you all the praise. As we raise our hands before you today, as we lift our hands in worship, Lord, as we open our mouth to adore and bless your name, touch us, Lord, one by one. Teach us, Heavenly Father, the greatness of thy kingdom. Help us to understand and acknowledge, Lord, the presence of your Holy Spirit in our midst, Lord. We worship thee, Jesus. I worship you, Jehovah. I bless your holy name and I bless your powerful name. For you are God in the highest. We bless you, Jesus. Thank you, Spirit of the Lord.
Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Siyakubonga kosuche esi. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah.
we glorify your name. Hallelujah. 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 Can you tell the person that is next to you, it's nice to be in the house of the Lord. You know, it is nice to be in the house of the Father. Hey, what a day it is to be in the presence of the Almighty. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let me take this time to welcome you all one by one in the mighty name of our Lord and Savior Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Can you touch the person that is next to you and just tell that person, welcome. Welcome to the house of the Lord. Welcome to the house of grace. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Can you just shout and scream one more time to make a holy noise to the Lord? Yay! 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 You are holy! You are holy, Jesus! You are holy, Father! You are holy, Jehovah! Blessed be unto the name of the Lord! Hallelujah! Are we all excited to be in the presence of the Lord? Are we happy? Yeah. Serious, serious. Kaniti. Kaniti, serious, serious, serious. Yeah. Hallelujah. Yeah. I believe that today when we leave this house, our lives will have turned 360 degrees around. And we will never remain the same in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. 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 Akilitwe. Hallelujah. So, hallelujah. Uchesu lo unobubele ngamimina.
Uchesu lo unobubele
Uchesu lo unobubele ngamimina.
Uchesu lo unobubele ngam. Uchesu lo unobubele ngam.
Uchesu lo unobubele ngamimina.
Greetings in the name of Jesus. There was two sick people in my family. The first one is my elder brother. He had a pain that was terrible for many, many years, to such an extent that he will even fail to do his work. I came here to the church, I bought anointing water, I gave it to him to drink, and now he is healed. The other one is my elder sister who was bedridden. She was also experiencing diarrhea, and she couldn't do anything. She was sick when she was in Mokopani. I came to the church, they gave me their prayer line number. I SMS'd it at home so that they can call the prayer line to be prayed for. Indeed, they did likewise. They called the church she was prayed for, and now she is healed. She is even able to walk. I thank God for that.
I greet you in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. My name is Pastor John Batista.
I come
from Madagascar Island.
Madagascar.
This Monday. My testimony is, I have three testimonies of healing. Since 2 years, I have been having problem of eyes. And they booked me for operation. I could not even read my Bible.
But
when I came here, I met our daddy. He told me, you will not be operated. Don't go for operation. God will heal you. It was on Thursday. After he prayed for me, I went to the hostel. In the night when I woke up to pray, I discovered that I can read my Bible again. The second testimony, I was having pain on my side more than 20 years. The doctor could not see anything. So when I came here, Apostle said, I saw you have problem in your side, but God will heal you. The pain was so much that I have stopped taking soft drink. But after the prayer of Thursday, I started taking soft drink. I am healed. The third testimony was, on the service of Friday, one of the prophets came to me and said, you have problem of cramp, but God has healed you. I testify that it is true. I used to have cramp, especially when I was doing dry fasting. I would not be able to raise very well my leg. But from now, everything has gone. I give glory all to God. And I thank God for this commission.
And
the Lord bless Apostle and all the Amen. Members.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
I greet you all in Jesus' name. I would like to thank God about what He has done for me. Tuesday, God has blessed me with a job at Department of Health here in Tembisa Hospital.
Tembisa Hospital. Amen.
I greet all saints in the wonderful name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Madume go ba ena ka moka ka lena le lebotsela Jesu Kriste.
I had a court case that was going on and on for 7 years.
Ve ke na le tsheko ya mengwaga ye meshupa.
Daddy prayed for me.
Mo apostola ba ile ba nthapelela.
In November last year the court case was set down and everything is okay.
Ka godi ya no fomere ngwaga o feta molatola ile wa fela and dilo ka moka di buetse sekeng.
The second testimony that I have, I wanted to apply for a car. I went to the bank and the application was not successful. Then I listened to a lady testifying here to say she applied through electronic.
Because of that, I also did the same.
And my application was successful. I want to give praise to God for that.
Amen. What kind of a car is it, Mama?
It's a Jeep Wrangler.
God blessed her with a Jeep Wrangler. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I greet you all in the name of Jesus, amen. We want to thank God at Simono family yesterday as we arrived home. God blessed us with a house in a suburb.
Amen. Greetings in the name of Jesus. On the 4th of February, I was involved in an accident and my car was damaged. Now I would like to thank God for preserving my life. Last week I had a knee problem. I couldn't walk.
Maraka Friday ke ile ka tla kerekeng, one of the prophets will unrapella ka gona o sepela ke rata o leboga modimo ka ngwelelaka.
On Friday I was here in the church and one of the prophets prayed for me and now I would like to thank God for the healing that he has given me on my knee. Amen.
Greetings in the name of Jesus.
Madume le neng la Jesu.
I'm here to give thanks from God because he blessed me with a new job from one of the mines in Mpumalanga.
Greetings in the name of Jesus. I'm Tabiseng from Bushbuck Ridge. On Wednesday, I was here in the service and the apostle said we must receive our jobs when he was declaring.
And
at that time, my cell phone was off. At that time, they were busy calling me to tell me that tomorrow I have to start working at 8 a.m. I was not knowing anything. I slept until 9:10 a.m. the following day.
Kire phone kena go tswa ka head office ya mo ke berekang gona ba re why ke sa tla mosebetseng ba mphonetse mabane.
They called me again to ask me why didn't I come to work because they called me yesterday.
Ke gopela gore ke gopela gore ke hlape fast ke fihle ke tlo thoma le mo le gore ke late.
O thomile joale sesi.
Ke thomile.
Oh, she's thanking God for a new job. Amen.
I greet you saints in the wonderful name of Jesus.
Ke le dumedisa ka moka ba ena ka lena le lebotse la Jesu.
I would like to thank the grace that God has granted us, me and my family.
And another
family, we travel from Swaziland every Sunday to come to church.
We thank
God for the grace, for the affordability to do it. My second testimony is my husband had been qualified a year ago for a certain position at his workplace.
Molekani waka ke khale le re ba swanetse go re ba dule se go ba se itseng kwa mmerekong.
he was told to apply for promotion on variation. Something that he did last year in April. Nothing has been happening since then. And ever since we came to Charis, we've been praying that God may break the spirit of stagnation in our lives. Last week, Sunday, after church, when we got home in Swaziland, he got a call that he's supposed to go to the government offices for the variation on promotion.
And
when he got there, he was told that he should be awaiting their call anytime because something is being prepared for him. Testimony number three, I had a problem with my feet. I work for a bank and it's a very demanding job. I stand for the whole day. And my feet get swollen to such a point that I can't even drive. 2 or 3 Sundays ago when we came to church, the apostle gave us the small anointing water bottles. When we got home at night, I sprayed the anointing water on my feet. And my feet have never been this better.
Amen. Amen.
I greet you all in the name of Jesus. I'd like to thank God because he has blessed me with a job at the SAPS. And greetings in the wonderful name of Jesus. I'm here to thank God for what he has done for me. He has blessed me with a better job at the presidency.
Greetings in the name of King Jesus Christ. I started being a member here in Charis. I've always been supplying my CVs in hospital because I was looking for a nursing job.
Friday ni fukena mpundi ni submit CV ibi ni hlwela kuta ni swona ku ninge elungu kuta akereke ni khongela ni ri andlwini.
On Friday, I went somewhere to take my CV and I was late. I saw that I can't make it to come to church. I prayed when I was at home. Hallelujah. When I finished my prayer, a call entered from Kastenhof Private Hospital. They wanted to come and they wanted me to come and work at that moment. I thank God for that.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I would
like to greet everybody in the name of Jesus.
Last week I came here, they
were holding me on both sides because I was blind.
So when
I got here, they prayed for me. Now I am healed and I can see again. My eyes became blind on Saturday when I was taking a decision to come and fellowship
here.
On Sunday, my eyes became worse, and in my heart, I just told myself that Satan is a liar, I must go to church. I took my smallest child and told him or her to hold me by my hand to come to the church.
So
when we got to the gate, my child turned back and they helped me to enter the church. I was only seeing the people who were near me. I couldn't see far.
So kireke irile ge etjwa and then batho ba tsamaya nna ka shala ke ditse mo stilong ke sa bono ke sa gone o tseba gore ke tlo ya kae ke tlo mo because matlhoka a tswalegile go tswalega.
After the service I was just seated on a chair and I was wondering where am I going to go because my eyes were closed.
So babe ba nyakela one of the pastor and then unrapella ka be ke ba right no ke a bona ke rata o leboga modimo ka seo.
Oh mama o fodile o thomile go bona ka yona nako yona ge ba fetse go rapelela.
Ke thomile bona kana kana yona yewe and then ka be ke sepela ke tsa make ya ga because ne ke sa gone ne ke dutse ke sene motho ke tsa mang le yena so ba re go rapella ka tloga ka sepela ka ya go ntlo.
O le tee.
Eya.
Glory to Jesus.
Amen.
I couldn't see at all. And they organized one of the pastors to come and pray for me. And instantly after the prayer, I started seeing and I was able to go home on my own. Thank you, Jesus.
I greet you all in the name of Jesus.
Madumego lena lineng la Jesu.
Kitomilo kula ka 2013.
I started to be sick in 2013.
But the doctor ne di sa tsebe gore ke tshwere ke.
But the doctors, they couldn't find what was wrong with me.
But finally, ba njwetsa gore ke na le bone marrow cancer.
Bampotsa gore nna ke na le kankere ya marapo.
So ka 2014 towards the end of 2014 ka tla le mekerekeng.
Towards the end of 2014 I came with my wife to the church.
So situation ya ka ne le bad ne ke sa khone tsa mana ke sa khone tsa next.
My situation was so bad that I couldn't even walk or do anything.
A ke fitla mekerekeng the first thing prophet ha fitla before a bula service.
When I arrived here the first thing when that the apostle did before he can start to preach.
O ile ara hona le motho o mong o na le cancer mo and haji o lahlelwa ke hlalwane.
He said there is somebody here with cancer, that person doesn't have appetite and he's even losing his memory.
Ke ile ka tla prophet o ile nrapella ampotsa re ke fodile.
I came forward, apostle prayed for me and he said you are healed.
So from 2015 ke ntse ke sebedisa metsi ya kereke motho ya kerekeng.
Ever since then I've been using Charis anointing water.
So last week Friday ne ke ile go doctor as my routine checkup.
On Friday I went to the doctor just to do a checkup.
So wa ke fitla go doctor mpotsara my blood is clear. Maria ka a clear hona no everything is right just fela tlamile ba gate gore e ska ya boya hape.
Hallelujah. As I'm talking to you right now, they said my blood is clear, the cancer is no longer there.
And I say ke khono tsama because never itse mona ba re never ke khono tsama happen without the aid of somebody or
they had said unto me that I can never walk without being helped by anybody, but now I am able to walk on my own.
Because ba itse masapo aka cancer e sentse masapo aka ka ofela mo mmeleng.
They had said that the cancer has destroyed all my bones in my body.
But hona no nke khono tsama hantle bile ke a phakisa ke tsamane.
Hallelujah. Now I can walk very well and even if I want to rush I can even run. Hallelujah.
My second testimony is that since 2013 ba ile ba discharge ka mosebetsing.
My second testimony is that ever since 2013 I was laid off at work.
My bones are damaged.
Never after the report of the doctor concerning my bones.
January this year they called me.
In January this year they called me.
Bamfonela bampotsa re ba batla a progress report ya doctor.
They said they are looking for the progress report from the doctor.
So ka ya ka ba fa yona.
I gave it to them.
So ba fonela le doctor.
They called the doctor.
Doctor aba and clear hore nka gotlela mosebetsing.
The doctor cleared me that I can go back to work.
So ke na le 2 months ke sebetsa ona.
Now it's been 2 months that I am back at work. I'm thanking God for what he has done for me. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Nam fushale vito Jesu Kristu Nazareth. Amen.
Greetings in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth.
Namela leswi xikwembu xingana endlela swona.
Even me, I would like to thank God for what he has done for me.
Sungule nghena la 2013.
I started coming here 2013.
Evia hi March mfundisi vato vatani prophet hi 3 March.
On the 3rd of March apostle prophesied me.
Va ku ri xikwembu xiri ntatira halawa.
Xikwembu xiri?
God xikwembu xiri va ku xikwembu xiri ntatira ga setrala.
God said God is saying that you will work this side.
Impela swivatano ntira ga setrala.
Indeed it was like that I worked on the side that God the apostle prophesied that I will go.
Mara la antra kona antra le pa broke.
The problem is that I was under contract.
Sentrin ku sesa malemba la antin lembeler.
I worked all those years until this year.
Lembeler hi March again.
This year, this month,
March,
on the 1st of March,
Sitrela Company Health Science.
Company, yeah?
Health Science, Imperial Health Science.
Okay, I'm working for Imperial Science.
So it's in permanent.
Now I've been permanented. God also gave me an extra. They are taking me to school.
For 3 years.
The company is the one that is paying, and tomorrow I'm starting. I'm thanking God for that. Greetings in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I'm Nkateko from Zanin. It's only 3 weeks I'm coming here.
On Wednesday,
Pastor
Batei, yina ke nga tireki, he receive the job.
The apostle said that those who are not working receive your jobs.
So I received the job.
Now God has blessed me with a job.
Yeah.
There was something that was bothering me in my stomach. I bought anointing water. I drank it. When I'm sleeping, I would feel something moving, even at the back. I prayed.
So every day I drink that anointing water.
I would drink that anointing water every day. Now I feel okay, and I'm thanking God for that.
Thank you.
Amen. Greetings in the name of Jesus. I've got just a small testimony.
2 weeks back, Pastor Willie Arafa anointing water.
The small one of the spray. On Monday, I used it when I was going to work. Or even on Tuesday. Because me and my wife were always looking for a car. We were just looking for a small car, a small buggy that can help us. On Wednesday when I got to work, the dealers started calling me without even me approaching them. They just told me that they've got a special which is coming to an end in that week. I asked them if they've got the bucket that I'm looking for. They said yes. I sent them all my paperwork. Now God has blessed that with a Nissan
NP200
Baki
2016
model. Amen. Greetings in the name of King Jesus Christ. My testimony is concerning the anointing water.
1 year 11 months.
I left my 1 year 11 months baby at home with my mom.
So one phone,
they call me to tell me that they can't sleep.
Past 11 to 12,
every night my baby will wake up just before midnight, and he or she will be crying. I decided to go home, and when I got there, when it was evening, I pray that God, tonight I want to sleep, and I also want my child to sleep. At that time that they were telling me that the baby will wake up and cry, it indeed the baby woke up and cried. I took anointing water and I gave to the child. Ever since that day on the 25th of February until today, the child sleeps peacefully. I thank God for that.
I greet you all in the wonderful name of Jesus Christ. Amen. I would like to glorify God through my testimony. God bless me with the car.
The name of the car?
It's a Hyundai Elantra 2016.
Hyundai Elantra 2016 model. Amen.
I greet you all in the name of Jesus. I would like to thank the Lord because on the 1st of February, I was blessed with a job.
I
had I was working as a general worker in a chemical company. On the 1st of March, I received an SMS that I mustn't go for lunch because the manager is coming to see me. So at 10 to 1, the manager was there. So I was promoted to be a manager without experience. I would like to thank the Lord Jesus for showing his mercy in my life.
Amen. Grata go leboga morena Jesu ka mosa wa bona bophelong byanga.
Nilumelisa batho bothe dzinan la mchizo wa shona ba Jesu Kristo. Amen.
I greet everybody in the name of our Savior Jesus Christ. I thank God he has blessed me with a job. I'm starting to work tomorrow. Greetings to everybody in the name of Jesus. I'm here to thank God he has blessed me with a job.
Charis, praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I have a few testimonies, but I will try to be as short as possible. The first testimony, in August last year, the apostle made a declaration that we will experience debt cancellation. 3 weeks later, Tswane Municipality cancelled a debt that I had with them of over
15,000.
And the second testimony, apostle prophesied to me and told me that I have a sister who's a sangoma. But he said to me, I will be the one to deliver her. So he prayed for me and anointed me. I went back home to my sister's place. I prayed for her. She was delivered. And now she knows how to read the Bible.
Brother, wait. Does she read the Bible because she has to, or is she born again?
She is 100% born again.
Hallelujah. Amen.
The third testimony is that in January the
25th,
in Sunnyside,
Pretoria Sunnyside,
people broke into my car and stole my laptop and my iPad. There were no witnesses whatsoever. So I ran back home and I took the anointing water. And I started praying to the God of TB Joshua and to the God of Apostle Makananisa. And said that I'd made a declaration to say that before the sun go down, I must have my stuff back. By the grace of God, before the sun went down, I received a call. And to make a long story short, I have my laptop and my iPad back. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
The last testimony is that I applied for a contract with a certain company in
Vereeniging.
But the requirement was that we should have, or the contractors should have, at least a minimum of 2 trucks. I didn't even have a buggy. However, by the grace of the Lord, the God who qualifies the unqualified, I got the contract. And now I'm employing people who had the trucks.
Amen.
Glory be to God.
Hallelujah. I greet you all in the mighty name of Jesus. I'm standing here to thank God for what he has done for me.
First week of February,
on the first week of February, I was here in the church.
Before
the apostle could lay his hand on me, he said, you are going to work. The following week after I left here, I received a call that was coming from the District of Health.
And I signed a contract.
I signed the contract. I have started to work on the 1st of March in a clinic. I'm thanking my God about that. Amen. Greetings in the name of Jesus. I've got just a small testimony. I was employed there at Agri as a learnership.
So, but they were very much arrogant on me.
The people who were supposed to teach me the job, they were so arrogant towards me.
Because they
were stealing money there at work, and I couldn't be one with them.
They were the ones
who were supposed to teach me how to do the work and send my report every month end. By God's grace, they were fired, all of them at work. The position that I was supposed to be taught for. Hallelujah. Now I am seated in her office and now I am permanently employed. I thank God for that. Greetings in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I'm lucky from Charis Makado. I'm thanking the grace of God upon my life. God has blessed me with a job in one of the companies
when
in
Makado.
I didn't even look for the job or even do an application. I thank God for that. Amen.
Ria tuarine ria haya Jerusalem. Ria tuarine ria haya Jerusalem. Jerusalem. Jerusalem rine. Yeah.
Can you clap your hands, you ululate for Jesus? Lea ropa jealous azanga irekele mututiki. Can you clap your hands, shout and scream to show appreciation for Jesus? Hallelujah. Can you tell the person that is next to you, hey, God is good. Everything na double double. Otsamaya ka mautu charise ko rata. Ene koloi ka sita o sa iko garachini ko vuche. Can you tell the person that is close to you, a car will never come to you, you have to go to the garage. At the garage is where they sell cars. Cars are not sold in the pulpit of the pastor. Hallelujah. Kichani mutse akere. Oh, ki ona Jeep Wrangler ye. Okay. Usarote ke botshatra ngwana papa. Are tweng papa. Hey. Yo. Nalela thaile mma.
Greeting in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Le rena re mopela ga lena ka go leboga modimo.
We are standing before you to thank the Lord only.
La mothomo re leboga mma le papa.
So the first thing I want to thank mama and daddy.
Le ba prophet le ba ruti ba.
And all the pastors and prophets in Charis.
Re se modimo a re letseng swana ke ka lebaka la tumelo.
We are here or we are what we are today because of faith. So we just told ourselves that we need a baki. So those 2 past weeks. So Apostle prayed for us and gave that small water. So now we used the water and the car came. We didn't even call the car to come. So in other words, we just want to say thank you, Lord.
The name of the car.
Koloi livichola yonaina.
MP200.
MP200.
1.6.
Oh, bare mmala wa yona ke white. Are twenga mma.
Ke le dumedise ka moka ka lebitsa la morana Jesus.
Greetings in the name of Jesus.
Le nna ke DMi mo le boga modimo.
So I'm just here to thank the Lord also. I don't have so many ways, I just want to thank the Lord. Amen. I'm just happy. Can you clap your hands? All you lay to glorify the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Vusha muto leng khafu ropi ile ako vusheje. Can you clap your hands, ululate, and glorify the name of Jesus? Aritweng baha mulukumi.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Lerna ritilemoto leboa mudimu for.
We are also here to come to thank the Lord for.
For fulfilling one of our dreams to drive
better car.
It's really when we were busy with this transaction. What I've learned is that if you are a Charis member. When you buy a car, it has got nothing to do with the numbers on your pay slip, but the grace.
Okay. How reka koloya ayika tabaya uridi no moro chawe badi ngwaling mo pay slip idi ringi ni liyaka urika urelo ironana.
This the previous owner of this car, I was told that he's a millionaire.
Yo, munga koloyo na iyo unilala matomo bariki mo ramashili.
So le rena ra re awara re ka le di millions tshi di fitli mara re driver koloi ya di
we also agree that even though the car is been driven by millionaire, we are also going to drive it though those millions haven't reached us.
Rata o leboa ditapelo tsa mama le daddy.
So we love to thank the Lord because of mama and daddy's prayers.
Thank you for always pushing us, for always encouraging us.
Re leboa gapele tsa lena lo re thotlhele tsa lena.
To dream a bit higher.
Ore re no dula re lorile re lora tsa gole tsa godimo.
Kirata Olewa again for Mudimu Kipa, our biological parents.
And I want to thank the Lord for keeping our biological parents also.
Yes, it's good to see them smiling when they see one of the fulfillment of their prayers. Yes, these are the people,
you can never act for them and or fake things towards them.
They know where you're coming from. I also would like to
I want to also thank my beautiful model.
She always encouraged me to dream higher because now I think I was the chief here, the Skepsel mode, Charis.
I was the chief of Skepsels,
maybe
in Charis.
I was just happy with going to heaven one day.
For me, it was something from A to B only. So I want to thank the Lord for prayers to open our eyes.
Yes. Yes, it's Audi. Q7.
Q7, 2013 model.
3.0 TDI.
3.0 engine capacity TDI.
Yes, the sport package.
You know my way. Bari ki package ya sport. Ki bona ntwe ngwe ba engwadile na mo bari gore bari ki 4 gore bari ki ira horeng.
Apparently it's got something to do with uneven terrain.
Oh, but I would say my modi plekeng chow kardina li mi kotana idea ye mabuzi.
Yeah, ki balance agabo yo.
Letuila kere. Neki tushali na bara yati balance ya tama ya buzi. Amen. Are you going masubuzana? Hey.
Amen.
Amen. I want to really thank the Lord.
And the God of this house.
Le mudimu wantoi.
Yes, rata go leba modimo.
No, you just want to thank the Lord. Ba re malaking a la re botsa bo mlokomi.
Kid Lesia White.
Hey. Na ke a toloka sgoa mara ye yona o ka re tampalela. Ba re king?
Lesia.
Lesia, Lesia or Lesia?
Lesia G L A
G O Lesia White. Tswa. A reetse. O sa tsebe sgoa mo Charis ko rata. Glazier White is the color of the car. Can we clap our hands? We ululate to bless the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Are you doing this? Greetings in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah.
In the offices to apply for.
I just went to the bank to go and apply for.
But they turned me down.
Bang, anecha.
Charis television.
So I was watching Charis television.
One sister was testifying for electronic application.
So another sister was saying she did electronic application.
Then honamo, I knelt down before the TV and I said.
So naka kuna mapila TV and.
God of Apostle Makananisa.
Mudimu Apostle Makananisa.
That's what I'm going to do myself.
Ken najononkyo itoma idu idirandreyo. I'm asking for your help.
Then I went back to the office.
Kaya ko kavuela ko di officing.
Kaira electronic application.
Kaldirandrey ba ibichanka swa electronic.
The same bank that did.
Banka yonayela yangungane chayela.
Approved it.
Ba approve.
By the grace of the church.
Ya kaya puteo ba ya utolala karantui.
Amen.
So ke rata o lebo modimo.
The name of the car ke Jeep Wrangler.
Koloi ba e bitsa Jeep Wrangler.
Unlimited Rubicon.
Awa ko bulele botsi se se go se sa o se ya pa. Enge?
Ke Jeep Wrangler unlimited ke Rubicon. Engine capacity ke 3.8.
Unlimited ingi?
Unlimited, that's just what they call it.
Jeep Wrangler unlimited.
Unlimited. And okay. The name of the car ke Rubicon.
Oh, Levicho yakinya ka yona ye we Rubicon.
Okay. Engine capacity ki
3.8 ki engine capacity.
Orange.
Awa. Arno dumela ba re ki orange. Hey. Tadia riyanina. Can you clap your hands? Ululate, shout and scream for Jesus. Hallelujah. It's a mayagama utukurata. Let us hear the next testifier.
I greet you all in the name of Jesus.
Greetings in the name of Jesus.
I just want to thank God.
Geratona lewa mudim.
For this vehicle.
Kakuluye akiboni likuluye on.
This one was released here with a prophecy on the last Sunday of January.
Yeah, ilukulu chimoka prophecy asonta ya mafelelo.
Yes, of January, one of the prophets located me and said that.
Amo prophet town tola aruna.
Yes, God is showing him that I'm going to buy a baki.
Modimo mponcha ora ke tota kereka baki.
Within a month.
We did so fail.
And indeed, in Jesus' name, 2 weeks later, the car landed. I thank God.
What's the name of the car and the color of the car?
It's Chevrolet.
Chevrolet.
1.4 utility buggy.
1.4 engine capacity utility buggy.
Amen.
And the color is?
White.
And the color is white. Can you clap your hands? All late, shout and scream for Jesus. Hallelujah. Let us hear the next one. We are waiting.
Amen.
This car belongs to Mama. We brought it here.
It says it's been bought
for long. We just want to thank the God of Charis.
It's after 2 months.
She got a job and she bought a new car after 2 months.
Kia Rio hatchback.
It's Kia Rio hatchback.
2016 model 1.2 engine.
2016 model 1.2 engine capacity.
2016
model. Mala.
Kia maroon.
Eh?
Maroon color.
Eh? Yeah. Where is Mala ki maroon? Arno Dumel.
Hallelujah.
Amen. I want to thank the Lord God of Charis. I want to thank Mama and Daddy for their prayers and encouragement. I never thought that one of these days I would buy a car. I can also see myself as an owner of a car. I was qualified on the 4th of December.
Only with a green ID book.
Ka ID book o fela fela. I want to thank the Lord because Mama is always saying when you are here in Charis, when you are still walking on foot, you love it.
And then Mama God's will.
And then my son said, Mama, this car is called God's will. So now I believe another testimony is coming for a better car than this. Amen. Clap your hands for Jesus. Hallelujah. Are you thank Papa? Greetings in the name of Jesus. I just brought this car to come to thank the Lord.
Because
I just got the car. Because I was using the anointing water, drinking it. So then I just thought I have to come and thank the Lord for this beautiful car. So that I can get more or other beautiful cars that are beautiful more than this one. I really want to thank the Lord. Bari king ile bichola yana papa.
NP Nissan.
Nissan NP 200.
Nissan.
Amen. Malawa yona. They say the color is white. Hallelujah. Clap your hands, ululate, and glorify the name of the Most High God. Glory to Jesus. Are you thank sisi?
I would also like to thank God. God bless me with this car. I fetched it on Friday. 2 weeks ago, Papa gave us the small anointing water. I went home and I ministered it. I sprayed it on my head. And I started naming everything that I
need from
God. I didn't know that the car would come so quick. I'm still shocked even today. Because it's a miracle. There were calendars that Papa gave us.
Some calendar che Papa inkileng arinia.
I write down everything that you want. Before that date, it would have manifested. Now on the calendar, I'd put at least from June, God can give me a car. And when I went into the car dealership, I wasn't even applying for the car. It was during my, because I knew I wouldn't qualify not at this stage. So I was just going to lunch and this, I was passing by the Renault Clio and the guy just said, let's see if you can qualify for a car. Then I applied. They didn't come back to me that day. Then the following day I said, you know, but that car, that Renault Clio that I applied, let me apply for a smaller car, a Polo Vivo. Second hand that I can afford. So they called me from Renault Clio. They said the bank approved you.
So I'm phone bank approved.
And then Polo Vivo, they said they approved you.
Bare ka Polo Vivo ba approved le gona.
So the following day when they came to fetch me to go and
so
fetch
the Renault,
then I remembered in my heart that I used to sing a song that I will drive a Hyundai Elantra.
So gopola rena ke rata kudu bolela rena ke to re ile Hyundai Elantra.
Whenever I sit on the road, I would say, that is my car. So when I was about to enter the kumbi of the Renault guy, they just called me from Ande and said, Bari, we approved you. Then I jumped out of the car. I said, you know, I will follow afterward. You can go alone. So then I decided to go for the Hyundai Elantra
because
it was my heart's desire. I just want to thank God.
So
between me and my heart, I know that this is God's grace. Not really affordability or a very good credit record. I would like to thank God.
Malawa koloi bariki ingisisi.
Kichakol ki Hyundai Elantra 1.6 executive.
Hyundai Elantra 1.6 engine capacity.
Executive.
And then Malabar King.
Charcoal.
And the color they say is charcoal. Hallelujah. Can you clap your hands for Jesus? Let us take our hands to all these cars. Let us all say in the name of Jesus, you are blessed and highly favored by the Lord. Your cars are covered by the blood of Jesus. You are blessed as you go in. You are blessed as you go out. You will never make an accident with this car. You will never stuck along the road in the name of Jesus. You will never lack money to pour fuel in your cars. In Jesus' mighty name, you are covered by the blood of Jesus. Amen. Can you clap your hands, you ululate, shout and scream for the glory of the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. You'll be reversing your cask. Let us allow the last one to go out first, and all of us will go out one by one. You will be watching them. Let us. Hey, what are you? Mara kiche ni buse ne? Hey. Ani timu timu pala balo ikale buse. Iska fela na pelo ina. Etan papa. Kasi chai se manwa muruta. Babana di reverse so it makes you to look at them so closely. Ebele udume ore khanti na ya ka yona ke to irekane. Ai reki ka molomo mwana papa ere kwa ka udumela lo ya garaging. When you believe and you go to the garage, you'll find it. But if you udula go ga yena, batho a dula o lebella tsa ba bangwe di fita ka tsela o tba botshate. Hey. Har libele mare ke koloya di milione asin na batho ba modimo tsano li expect or na ke tsa mae ka mautule ka mogwao le na le mo mama hey le le level le masubutsana ka moare ya koloya a kere ke tuele ba bolela. Joseph, can you help the lady there to go out with the car? She's taking long. Bona se suru reilai. Na ke ne ke na no college ke tsa tsamaya ko khatsa gashe. Fitala ke bona matharisi batho mo direka ka re yo. Kanti dia tholala le mo kereke. It's nice to be in the house of the Lord, isn't it? Can you ululate and glorify the name of Jesus? Hallelujah. Can we all stand up? We will be finding a song or a worshiping song. I believe Apostle will be coming to the front in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Can you ask the person that is next to you, are you ready? We took it to Jenna. You know, we are recording what you are doing. Come up here in a vicinity. Hallelujah. 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 Let us raise our hands. We are going to worship the Lord.
Our God is an awesome God in rain. From heaven above with we storm power and love. Our God is an awesome God. He's an awesome God in rain, from heaven above with wings, strong power and love. Our God is an awesome God.
shout, screams, praise.
Congratulations, God bless you.
So, on my visitors, I heard people from my brother who's going tomorrow.
Okay, from
Madagascar.
Yeah.
He stayed with us almost 10 days.
Almost
10 days.
Almost machachali sumi.
I believe he learned a lot. But one thing that I wanted to tell him is, when you go back, with the anointing you have received, you will blow
Satan
away from you. God bless you. And also we enjoy to be with people from India. I was trying to show them that God can still use you. They are excited. Those ladies. How do you feel, Baba? Especially this short lady.
Mama, Baba,
very happy.
Very happy.
Yeah,
very,
thank
very.
Thank you. Thank you, Charis. Thank you.
Thank you, Charis.
Thank you, Charis.
Amen.
Thank you. Is coming back, so let's be ready to serve God faithful.
In faithful,
are you hearing me?
Amen.
Yeah, we must not tolerate sin. We must never tolerate sin. I'm saying it again, we must never compromise because Jesus is coming back. All of us, we must be in heaven. How many of you want to go to heaven one day? Please, Jesus is coming back. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Can we read Acts 22? When I was reading 24 to 29.
Chapter 22.
Acts. I was learning something there. I was very, very surprised. Verse what?
Verse 24 to 29.
The commandment, ordered that Paul be brought into the barracks, and that he be examined by scorching, in order that might learn why the people cried out thus against him. But when they had stretched him out with the thongs, Paul asked the centurion who was standing by, "Is it legal for you to flog a man who's a Roman citizen and uncondemned, or without a trial?" When the centurion heard that, he went to the commander and said to him, What are you about to do? This man is a Roman citizen. So the commander came and said to Paul, "Tell me, are you a Roman citizen?" And he said, "Yes." And the commander replied, "I purchased this citizenship for a big price." Paul said, "But I was born a Roman." Instantly, those who were about to examine and flog him withdrew from him, and the commander also was frightened, for he realized that Paul was a Roman citizen. and he had put him in chains. Let's pray. Father, thank you for your word. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
I was reading this and I began to learn a lot about the power of a citizenship. The power of a citizenship. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because if you can read here, you can hear clear that the citizenship was an issue that can make people to refrain, even not to touch you.
Not to touch
you.
You
read here, you find that Paul was arrested because his mind was to reach Rome. Was ruling everywhere. The Bible says, where we have read, he acquired a citizenship. Before he reached there, he acquired citizenship. Because he knew that he had to be there. But now you can see that the people were in Rome, not all of them acquire citizenship in a right way. Because we are reading about this man who said, you know, me, I got this citizenship with a big price. But here we have not read about how Paul get that citizenship. So that's what I want to talk about, the power of a citizenship. Because when I was reading the Bible, I found that we are citizens of heaven. Tell a neighbor, I'm a citizen of heaven. So if you are a citizen of heaven, there are rights and also there are privileges. So you can see by the citizenship, Paul show his rights. He saw that they've arrested him and they wanted to flog him. In fact, they wanted to torture him. And he understand who he is by that time. And he said, I'm a Roman citizen. Because he knew that if he's a Roman citizen, they won't have power to do what they are doing. I don't know if you're hearing that. This man understands the power of citizenship, which we, as Christians, we are failing to understand our citizenship. He said, I'm a Roman citizen. And the Bible says, they began to ask each other questions and say, hey, is he a Roman citizen? If we beat him, we'll be arrested. If we fight this man because of his citizenship, we are in danger. I don't know if you're hearing it. And the Bible says, and the Bible says they refrain from that. Their plans failed. Remember, they wanted to torture him. They wanted to put him in pressure. They wanted to make him to suffer. But because he understood where he belonged, he used his grounds of understanding where he come from. He understand where he comes from. And he used the opportunity to deal with the situation. Can I tell you this? When you are a citizen, you must know the right of being a citizen in that place. No one can just tamper with you. No one can just play with you. I don't know if you're hearing me. There's a scripture that I've read about Jesus. Let me give you that scripture. I found Jesus was telling the people around and Pilate, And he said to me, to him, he said, in John 18,
John 18,
if we read verse 36,
Malikabala verse 36,
he said, my kingdom
is
not of this
world.
If my kingdom is of this
world,
my followers will come and fight. I don't know if you're hearing that. Jesus was showing that he belongs somewhere. There's a citizenship of him. And he understands that what is happening to him is bad. But it was allowed from heaven where he
came
from. I don't know if you're hearing me. And he said, my kingdom is not of this world. Otherwise, my followers will fight. So in other words, what I'm facing, it has been allowed in my citizenship. It has been allowed to face what I'm facing. As I don't belong here, I must face this, and I must face this, because I don't belong here. But I won't die here. I belong somewhere. That's what my friend. Say your neighbor. Say my neighbor, I belong somewhere. I've got my citizenship. And I'm not afraid of what I'm saying. I'm not afraid of what I'm saying. If you read Luke 15, if you read from verse 11 to 17, we found a story, a prodigal son. A prodigal son. And the Bible says he went to another country. There's something that has touched me. If you can read from 16 to 17, the Bible says he forced himself to be a citizen in that country. And that's where he didn't have rights that he was having. Where he come from. He began to live with pigs. He ate the food which is not supposed to eat. Can we read verse 16 aloud? He says what? I can't hear you. Start from the beginning. Luke 15. Read 16 and 17. He says what?
Hearing.
Okay, look here. Let me read 16 for you. And he will gladly have fed on and filled his belly with the carapons that the hawks were eating, but if you can read, they could not satisfy his hunger, and nobody gave him anything. 17. Then, when he came to himself, in other words, when he came to his senses, he said, how many hired servants of my father have enough food and to spare, but I'm perishing, dying here of hunger. If you read that, you realize that this man came to his senses. This man began to understand his citizenship and say, I'm belonging here and I'm happy to eat the food of pigs. But where I come from, I cannot eat such kind of things. He came to his senses. That's also my friend. Today, you must come to your senses. You must know who you are. You must understand that you are not a failure. There are things you are not supposed to eat. This man was eating food of pigs. You know, there's another version that talks about swine. It's only when he came to his senses,
he said,
no. This is not my portion. I cannot die eating this. I remember where I come from. My father owned everything. I can rather go back to the land of my father. And when I reach there, I know that everything will be good. Even if I'm there. Even if I cannot be called a child there. But I won't eat what I'm eating. Listen to this. This man came to his senses. I want us to come to the senses of where God has placed us. There's a place where God has placed us. And sometimes, because of what we are eating, what we are seeing, our situations are affecting our sight. And we tend to forget where we come from. I don't know if you're hearing me. We tend to forget where God took us. God took us somewhere. We are created from Him. We can come back to Him. I don't know if you're hearing me. Jesus said, my kingdom is not of this world. I cannot fight because of this. I must meet this because I'm going somewhere. There are some things you are going through. You must not forget where you come from or where you belong. You are not there to die. Know your citizenship. You belong somewhere. Where you belong, there is no failures. Where you belong, there is no defeat. Where you belong, there is no shame. There is no harm. Where you belong, you are in a right time. You are in a position that God has placed you to be where He wants you to be. Don't blame yourself by what you are facing. If you know your citizenship, just use your citizenship. Understand that what you are facing is there for a short time. I don't know if you are hearing me. When I read Ephesians 2, from verse 18 to 19, the Bible says we have an access to the citizenship of our Father through the Holy Spirit. Can we read that verse there? In Ephesians 2,
chapter 2,
especially verse 18.
Kudu verse 18.
My friend, what I was facing wanted to hinder me and make me to forget where I belong. Let me read it. For it is through Him that we both now have an introduction or access by one Holy Spirit to the Father, that we are able to approach Him.
Amen.
Therefore, you are no longer outsiders, exiles, migrants, aliens, excluded from the rights of citizens, but you are now share citizens with the saints, God's own people. Can you see that?
Amen.
And you belong to God's household.
Amen.
When I read this, I found that they are rights. I'm in the Father's house. I'm in my Father's house.
They are the rights.
You are no longer an alien. You are no longer a foreign. You are inside where the rights of a sonship or a daughtership are belonging to you. Remember this. Sometimes when you are looking at this, you question, where is God? Where is God in my life? What is happening with me? You are where God wanted you to be. You just claim your rights. I don't know if you are hearing me. When you feel pain, you say, by the stripes, I'm healed. When you are poor, you say, my God shall supply. I don't know if you are hearing me. You need to quote scriptures. The scriptures are the will of your father. When you have access by the Holy Spirit, you can take your own rights.
Your
own rights. You have got your own rights. Can you see people who are chanting?
Mare, we are fighting for our own rights.
Silwela,
we are fighting.
Even you,
Liwena,
you stand up and say,
wabulele,
I've
got my own rights.
If people are reproaching me and are fighting me this way, I just speak one way. The battle belongs to God. The battle belongs to God. When they are pressurizing me, try to press me, I don't look in them or on them. I look in myself. He who's unto me is greater than who he is unto them. So always, you take your rights because you know where you belong. You know you are a citizen. From above, you cannot be defeated
when
here. If you are a citizen from above, I don't know if you are hearing me.
Tasha,
my friend, I'm a citizen. I'm not a foreigner. I'm a child of the living God. Listen to this. If you are hearing this message, from now on, you must stop praying to get something. This is your right. Healing is your right. Blessing is your right. Money is your right. Your father own heaven and earth. And you are a citizen there. You must walk on top of money. I don't know if you are hearing me. Because your father owns the money, all money. You cannot die here. You're a citizen. I don't know if you're hearing me. Are you a foreign? Are you an alien? Are you from outcast? You're a child of the living God. If you're a child of the living God, claim your things. Take them by force. They belong to you. Receive your rights. Receive what you've been praying for. It's a right time because you're a child in the household. Whatever that is eaten in the house, you eat it also. I mean, you've got sonship. You are allowed to stand where Jesus is standing. You are allowed to stand with Peter and Paul. You are allowed to stand with all these biblical characters that are written. You are allowed to be like Job. If Job was rich, you can be rich. If Abraham was rich, you can be rich. If you are sick, you are allowed to be healed.
Say, I'm a citizen.
I'm not a failure. I'm taking my rights. Can you take your rights? What are you taking? What are you taking? Say, this is my right.
Say, this is my right.
What are you taking? Tell your neighbor, what are you taking? When I read Hebrews
12,
I want to read that verse. Verse 23. Hebrews.
By heaven.
I'm a citizen of heaven.
I
want to read verse
23. Verse 23.
Are you there?
Amen.
He says what? And to the church of the firstborn.
Amen.
Who are registered as citizens in heaven. And to the God who is judge of all.
Amen.
And to the spirits of the righteous, the redeemed in heaven, who have been made perfect.
Amen.
We are registered.
Amen.
In heaven. I want to tell you that. When you are a citizen, you are registered in heaven. You can be disapproved here.
Oka disapproval le fasting like again.
But you are known in heaven.
Mara wena wa tsebe ya kwa le godimo ng kwale.
I want heaven today.
Na ke nyaka le godimo le
khona. To speak for you.
Le o bolelele.
Because you are registered.
Ka le bakala
re wena o prophesy.
Modimo ba rekile prophesy eng.
Today
le khono le.
As your name is written about, whatever you say with your mouth, it shall come to pass. Because you are known in heaven. Say I'm known. Say I'm known in heaven. Listen, there are some people who are around you who are not even known, who are rejected, but that's those people. Always, God is speaking about them. And God wants to prove a point about their lives. As you are registered in heaven, here on earth, you are about to be examined. People will know that you are registered in heaven. I said people will see the fruits in your life. If you believe, say
amen.
If you read Philippians 1:27, I want to close. 1:27.
Philippians 1:27.
Pastor
said,
hey, are you registered?
Or you are still going to register?
If you read 27,
as
I'm closing,
chapter 1:27.
Only be sure as citizen, so to conduct yourself, your manner of life, worthy of good news of Christ, so that whether I come and see you or I'm absent, I may hear this of you, that you are standing firm in united spirit and purpose, striving side by side and contending with a single mind of the faith of the glad tidings. Can you see the verse there?
Amen.
The Bible says, your conduct, must be visible. Whether Paul say I'm there or not.
Paul or kiting uba kiting.
Listen to this. You cannot just be a citizen and you live a reckless life. Be a citizen of showing that you represent the kingdom you belong in. Your conduct, the way you do things, you have to be an example. People must be saved by me looking at you. The way you speak, the way you do things, people must be saved. Your conduct is important. Don't forget that your name is written by the living God. So your conduct is needed. Your character must show that you belong somewhere. I don't know if you're hearing me. God doesn't just want to bless you with wrong character. You must represent the kingdom you belong. I don't know if you're hearing me. That's what my friend. From now on, I know I'm a citizen of heaven. I will represent my Father God by whatever I do. Listen, you must show us. Your actions must show us. Whatever you do things must show us that you don't belong here. I don't know if you're hearing me. When you say things, we must see it. When you think, we must see. When you walk, we must see. Whatever you do, we must see. Because you don't belong here. There are some things you will never do. Because it's not done where you come from or where you represent. Sin cannot be mentioned. Because it's not part of the constitution of where you belong. There are things you can't do. You belong somewhere. There are some characters that you will just cut from the beginning. Because you belong somewhere. And all people who belong
they are not failures. They are not poor. They are not defeated. All people who come, they cannot be disappointed because they know the one they worship. He cannot fail them. I'm here to tell you, today, when God is giving you a citizenship, live like one. Show the character. There will be temptations that are coming to remove you or to defy you. But tell yourself, I don't belong here. I understand why I'm facing what I'm facing. It's because I don't belong here. I understand why I'm going through what I'm going through. My citizenship is of here. I belong somewhere. I don't know if you're hearing me. There have to be some characters, lifestyles, the way you conduct yourself, the way you behave, the way you think, must tell us where you come from. You know, we change from today. And we prove our citizenship that when we die one day, there is home. And this home is heaven. You know, sometimes you need to check yourself and say, why am I wasting time? Like, what is happening on the road here? You see some people cursing you when you are driving. But it's a waste of time. The person is in his car. I'm in my car. Can I show where I belong? I mean, if I'm answering, I'm in my car, you are talking. It's a waste. That's my friend. Those who know their citizenship, they cannot waste time with useless things. I don't know if you are hearing me. Many of you, you are beaten by the character. You are angry first. Think against other people. Evil thoughts. Many things. And such things are defying you to stand where you are supposed to be standing. Today, tell yourself, I want to have this citizenship and I want to live a holy life forever. My home is not here. My home is heaven. I don't belong here. I won't die here. Stop competing with useless things. Stop fighting for useless things. Whether you have money or not, one day you will die. Whether you go to hospital to see a doctor so that you'll be healed. But one day the same doctor and you will die. Can you just have a citizenship you represent? Because one day you will be going where you belong. You belong to heaven. You cannot waste time on useless things. You cannot waste time. Stop wasting time thinking about other people. Stop wasting time gossiping other people. Represent where you belong. Stop wasting time criticizing your neighbor. Stop wasting time making useless topics. Stop wasting time worrying around. Who told you that worry will pay you? Stop wasting time. Take your position and stand as a child of God and say, I'm facing this because I don't belong here. But my God will never leave me. Will never leave me because I belong. I belong there. I've got a citizenship. Though I'm feeling pain, this pain will never kill me. For me to live is Christ. But to die is gain. I won't worry about my poverty. I won't worry about my leg. God is on my side. I've got a citizenship. And one day my God will be visible. I will
live for him and I will die for him. We need Christians who are saying, come watch me, but we are not going back. We represent where we are going and we believe in our God. Hold
that
citizenship. Believe your God in front of you. He's leading you and you will never fail this year. Can I prophesy? God is making you example in your family. Are you ready to see that? If you are ready, come and receive Jesus. If you can see, many months I'm not calling altar call. But today is your day. Come now and receive Jesus. Come. You know your life is not right. Don't look at
anybody.
Come. Your citizenship must be of heaven. Come. Mercy. There was great and grace was free. Pardon there was multiplied
to me.
There my burden soul found liberty.
Et
Calvary. Come.
Great and grace was free. Pardon
there
was multiplied to me. There my burden soul for me.
Listen, what is important
is your
fellowship with Jesus. It's not money. It's not the houses. It's not things of this world. The Bible says, seek the kingdom and all shall follow. The decision you have taken today is so great. It's so wonderful.
Amen.
It's so wonderful. Can you clap your hands for
that?
Clap your hands for
that.
You have taken a decision that your friends can criticize you. Maybe your family won't understand you. But later they will know that Jehovah is with you. Carry on following him as you are starting today. Lift up your hands. Say, Holy Father,
Holy Father,
I know I'm a sinner.
I know I am a sinner.
But today, I come to you in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
I believe. As I am coming to you now. You are cleaning me. And you are washing my sins away.
And you are washing my sins away.
With the blood of Jesus.
With the blood of Jesus.
I believe you are my Father today. And I'm your child.
And I am your child.
And my sins are gone.
And my sins are all gone.
I believe today. I am receiving a citizenship. I believe. My past life is gone. And I am a new creature. Thank you, Father. For salvation. In the name of Jesus.
Of Jesus.
Can you just clap your hands for them? Welcome to the family of God. Welcome to the family of God. are not changing. Say, you hidden demon. I can't hear you.
You hidden demon.
You have been hiding in my life.
You have been hiding in my life.
For many years.
For many, many years.
But today.
But today.
You are defeated.
You are defeated.
Can you speak like you are a citizen? Like you have got a citizenship. Say, you hidden demon.
You hidden demon.
In my life.
In my life.
You have been hiding for many years.
You have been hiding for many years.
Today.
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 You are leaving me.
You are leaving me.
Now.
Now.
Watch. 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 Just watch. You will hear. Watch, watch, watch. Watch, watch, watch. Look, watch. They are falling down. You will hear screams now everywhere. Look, look at this one. Watch. Put a mic in their mouth. Huh? I can't hear you.
Why?
Why?
I'm
why?
Saying why.
Why you love a kung fu?
Huh?
Why?
Why do you want to help her?
You were hiding.
How we defeat him?
You were hiding.
Why?
I'm asking you.
Nabutisa.
Were you hiding?
How defeat him now?
Yes.
Yes.
I was seated.
I was seated nicely. Why are you taking me? Where must I go? Where will I go if I leave you?
Leave her, leave
her. Where will I go? I want to leave
her.
I want to stay just here. I've closed everything.
Listen. The prayer you've prayed is enough. You were asking yourself, I can't even touch money. Why? Some of you, you are staying where you're not supposed to be staying. It's because of this hidden demon. Some of you debts. The life you are living is not your life. Father, can you show me those people? Those hidden demons. Touch them there. Locate them wherever they are. Those who are blocking jobs, marriages, finances, promotions, those who are bringing sicknesses. Watch. Arise. Gone are the days of playing with a demon. You are not living your life because of
Satan.
Holy Ghost, locate all of them. They are stealing your career. They are stealing your success. Some of you are not even visible. They put you in a cage. Today you are coming out. Say, you are coming out.
I'm coming out.
Say, I'm coming out.
I'm coming out.
Say, I'm coming out of the cage. Can you speak like you mean it? Say, I'm coming out. Say, I'm coming out. How can you just face one thing when there is fire like this everywhere? I'm seeing fire everywhere here. Fire everywhere. Those who wish you, they will ask forgiveness. Before they die, before they die, they will ask forgiveness. Let me say something before I close this. Because we are starting to pray. We want everybody to be prayed for here. You people, you have been waiting for your life. And Satan was delaying it to trouble you. You are not happy. The life you are living, you are not happy. But today, whoever caused that delay, I say that person is listening to me right now. If you have caused that delay, you are living right now. You are living. I say you are living right now. Come on. Come on. I can hear you. Come on. 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 Out. Come on. Come on. Come on.
Out. Come out. Come out. Come out. 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 Come out, 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 come out.
Come on!
Out, 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 Lila. Come out, 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 out.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Any delay that has been used against you, you have been longing for a while, for a long time. Any delay. Can you say, you delay?
You delay.
You have been planted in my life.
You have been planted in my life.
I uproot you.
I uproot you.
Out, 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 out,
out.
Come on, that. Watch, watch them. Come on, come on. Jump as you're commanding. Jump.
Out, out,
out. Out,
out. Come out.
Live my life. Out,
out, out,
out,
out,
out,
out, out,
out,
out,
out,
out, out, out, out, out,
out,
out, come out, come out, come out, come out, come out, out, out,
out,
out, out, out, out, out, out, out, out, out, out, out, out, out, out, out,
come on, come on, out, come on, come on,
Laela, 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 out. Out, 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 out.
In
out,
Jesus' out. Name.
Amen.
There's another group here. Attacks are happening.
The attack at the Diragana.
When you sleep.
Au Robal.
You hear me?
Liantua.
When you sleep.
Au your Robal.
They come and feed you.
Bataba ufadicho.
When you sleep. A spiritual wife and a spiritual husband. When you sleep, they press you down. When you sleep, they inject you. Father, can you show me such people? Others, they have got things they must vomit. Spiritual husband. Spiritual wife. Injections.
The injection shield.
Food.
Dijo.
Moving objects. Evil food.
Come
on! Say, help her, help her, help her, help her, help her. That lady there. The one who's coughing. I can't hear you.
I can hear you too.
Can, all day.
It's not possible. Why? It's not possible.
What is the meaning of that?
It's not possible. It's not possible.
This one is ours. She's mine.
Yeah.
Umunyechi.
Yes. Let me marry her. Yes.
Umunyechi.
Yeah. Yes.
The guy Rinki.
Yeah. Where is the ring?
What's the ring?
Show me. I've married her. It's not possible.
Umunyechi ka.
Where did you marry her?
Umunyechi ka.
Where?
Umunyechi na.
I've married her.
Wa.
Ka. Yeah.
Where?
Hey, akone.
It's not possible. The whole family is mine. It's mine.
Yeah.
I'm taking off your ring.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You are defeated. Leave her, she's free. That demon is coming out. Look at the stomach there. The stomach. The demon is coming out there. If they put a ring in your dream, I touch that ring. I touch that ring. That ring of bad luck. That ring of failure. Whatever they put on you, the moving object is coming out. It's breaking. It's breaking. Yeah? I can't hear you.
Don't take out my ring, I'm asking you. Because my life will be finished.
I remove it.
In
Jesus' name.
Amen.
Listen. If you are here.
How limo?
And you are waiting for money.
And we made you chalete.
There is no more delay.
I'll say no chianak.
I said there is no more
work.
That demon.
Timoni lela.
That is bringing delay in your money.
Kara,
I have casted it out.
Keep promotion.
Holy Ghost, can you locate such people? I'm seeing people who are waiting for money.
Chalet.
And nothing is happening. God is touching you wherever you are. Receive that. Take it. Take your money. Accident fund is coming to you.
Amen.
Provident fund is coming to you.
Amen.
All funds are coming. Take your money of promotion. I take it. Congratulations in
advance.
From now to June. I'm seeing people receiving finances. I said, don't be angry. When people are testifying.
Amen.
From now to June. Check your job. You'll see you are promoted double. You'll be surprised you are living another life. Listen. You'll be surprised. I don't know. That's why I say I don't know.
That's why I say I'm
seeing many weddings in
Charis.
Weddings.
Manyalo fell.
Look at that one.
Level laola.
Wedding.
Manyalo, manyalo.
Watch. Listen, I see even older people doing weddings. Others will wed twice, thrice. Because of money. Receive your money, take your money. Let me hear. What's wrong?
Wedding.
Can you get chatter?
No, another can be.
We cannot agree to that.
Lift up. Stand
make
up.
To stand.
And you get your chatter?
No.
No.
Not him. Hey.
Hey, hey, they popped that money from the bola.
They
are taking, they are busy taking it out. She can never get married. I have even taken the job. I'm standing while standing here. I'm speaking
while standing here.
You have been defeated. In Jesus' name.
Listen. You have to be the first in your family. To drive
4x4.
To stay in a mansion. To live a better life. Look at that one. Look at that one. Hey, yeah. Live there, live there, live there. I want to see
her.
Live there. She won't do anything to anybody. Won't do anything. It's a spiritual husband, this one. It's a husband. Are you a man?
Omonana.
You are not man. Look how she walks. Live there. I want. Live there. Let her walk. Look at that man. Look at that man. Look at how she walks. So now if she's not delivered, you'll marry her. You'll be surprised, you know, one day. She's not delivered, you marry her. She will ask you with a base and say, how are you? Bring water. And you're the husband, you begin to run. She needs deliverance so that she become a wife. Look at her, how she's walking. Look how she's walking. There's a music in the head. Shy away. Leave her. You see? So if she's not delivered, I'm touching your head. I touch that head. If I touch, I remove you in the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I declare you free today. In Jesus' mighty name. Be delivered. She's free. Dasa, can you touch your stomach, you?
Yes.
God has delivered you. Because you are worrying about finances. Nothing is moving. Where are you working? You are not working. Prepare to get a job.
Amen.
Is your year this year? There are some people who are here today that God has opened doors for them. I will speak not with pride, but with authority. That from now, before June, your family will admire you. Remember, listen, I'm not speaking with pride. I'm speaking with authority. Because the testimony is about to follow you. Take it. If you are here for business, I want to tell you, prepare yourself. You need to go home and choose some clothes and say, I don't want to wear the old things again. Prepare yourself. Walk like you belong somewhere. I say, walk like you belong somewhere. Listen. Remember that there are things you're not supposed to eat because you're a child of the living God. Not because you have got money, but because you belong somewhere. Today I prophesy you. As you are here, you are going to change how you dress, how you talk, how you walk, what you think. Even your thoughts will change.
Account.
Having a lot of money. I say, receive it.
I receive.
If you believe, shout.
Jump.
Welisha.
If you believe.
I will do.
Jump.
Welisha.
Jump.
Welisha.
If you believe.
I will do better.
Jump.
Welisha.
Listen, whatever I'm saying it,
yeah,
God is honoring you with it. When you reach home, please sit down and say, I don't want this chair. I'm tired of this bed. God is honoring me. When you reach home, go to that medication.
Samaya oyo di tarichela cha wona di pilisi.
As a medication.
Uri wena we di pilisi we.
Listen to me.
Chele cha unkwe botse.
I'm tired of you.
Ke khatetse ka wena.
Jesus died for me.
Jesu na unkwechi.
When you reach home.
Au fitaye.
When you don't have a child.
Au sina mwana.
Can you begin to write?
Toma unwala.
I want this kind of a prem.
Ke nyaka preme ya mufuta u.
I want this. I don't know if you're hearing me.
I can see what you're talking about.
If you believe, shout
out.
Hallelujah. I can't hear you.
I can hear you.
I can't hear you. I can't hear I know that many cars you have, the bank cars, they are empty.
I did not see.
But when you reach home, say yeah. Congratulations.
Well, it's on all.
Listen. Let me just point two or three. I know God has done it. That lady who's wearing green.
So appearing to it,
Mama, when you reach home, go and touch your refrigerator. Because I saw for you to have food. It's a struggle. Don't worry, don't worry. God knows you.
Thank you, Jesus.
When you reach home.
Thank you, man of God. Thank you,
Jesus. Tell that fridge.
Yes.
That I'm about to change you. You are small.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. You heard what I said?
I heard man of God.
You heard what I said?
I heard man of God.
Because a time of laughter, a
Jesus,
time of rejoicing,
amen,
has come upon your life.
Amen. Papa, last year you prophesied me.
Yes.
What to give me? Business.
You said I must go into a business.
You said to me, "Go, my sister, go and do that business of yours. You'll suffer the rest of your life." Man of God, that weight, I'm suffered too much now. I'm enough. I'm had enough.
You know, listen to the, what we speak here. It happens.
Yes. Amen.
I told you, go and do that business, but you will suffer.
Yes, man of God, you said like this.
But now you're suffering.
I'm suffering a lot, man of God.
Because you went to do it.
Now I'm not doing it.
You end up stopping.
Yes, I'm stopping everything. Man of God.
You were supposed to have listened to me. You stopped.
Nothing I can do. My husband is not.
You don't look at the cry of the children. You listen to what God said.
Amen. God said to me one day I was on the way, I'm selling. God said to me, what are you doing?
do my job, I do yours.
My sister,
let us not talk too much. I'm not used to that.
Thank you, Jesus.
I want to tell you that God has done it for you.
Thank you, Jesus.
Can you hear what she's
saying? Thank you, Jesus.
She met me and said, if you carry on with this business, you will suffer. She looked at the children crying. She carried on with the business. And she suffered too much. She ended up leaving. So, but I'm telling her now something else.
Oh my God. Thank you, man of God. Thank you.
I say now, go. And tell that refrigerator.
Yes, man of God.
Because there is no food now.
Yes, man of God.
You were supposed to have listened that
day.
Now do it like this. You refrigerator.
Yes, man of God.
I'm about to change you.
Amen.
You're not part of me.
Amen.
Some of you do it on your car.
Oh my God. Thank you, Jesus.
Do it on your plate.
Thank you, Jesus.
Say, I'm making you favor.
Oh my God.
I'm just sleeping on you this week. You bet I'm just sleeping on you this week. Some bet when you sleep on them. When somebody's passing outside of the house. When you are turning. That bet says, sorry. That bed is leaving you. That room is... You are leaving that room. You are leaving that flat. Receive your house.
I receive.
Receive your car.
I receive.
Receive your heart desire.
I receive.
God bless you.
Keep watching Charis Missionary Church.